this kid, to me, is the best offensive player in the tri-state. He's one of the top players in all of America.
Here comes Matheis now working. Fires one home.
He's a premier athlete, though. This kid trains all season long, in the fall, in the winter, to become the best lacrosse player he can be.
Matheis now firing and scores. He's putting on a show.
His change in direction is borderline obnoxious when you think about it. The way that he separates, he gets teammates involved. In 2009, the Tri-State MVP was Matt White. We know what he did for the University of Virginia, capturing a national title and being all-tournament member. In 2011, Nikki Galasso, last year's recipient of the award, was the Rookie of the Year in the ACC. And this year, it's Case Matheis. And you can't think of a better player and a better kid to get this award, so congratulations.
Thank you very much, Clark. I appreciate it.
His change of direction is borderline obnoxious when you think about it. The way that he separates, he gets teammates involved. His first step is reminiscent of the great Mikey Powell from Syracuse, who was a four-time first-team All-American. I think Case Matheis is that good.
We'll be right back.
Talk about some players in this game. First for Darian, he is etching his way into the lore of all-time greats in the game. Case Matheis is dynamic.
Dynamic's a great word. Electric's another one. You talk about a guy who's got terrific feet, gets in and out of the defense. He's very tough to match up with individually. You're looking for people two and three times to get to him with slides. And even when you do that, he finds a way to make his teammates better. Balanced score, guy who does everything well, and he's going to look for a great game today.
As a sophomore a year ago, scoring 9 goals in a game was exciting for Case. The fact it was the state final, that's legendary, folks. Look at the all-around game, 22 and 21. The junior committed to Duke. Now Murphy back to Case Matheis once again. Look at Case taking a look at the whole field right now. Case turns inside, cross field he goes. Now a big blast and a goal! Here comes Darian now on the move. Scotty Waters into the zone. Scotty drops him off. Big one from Case, and he got it. Oh, Case Matheis blasted one past the keeper.
Here's my key, philosophy. A freak like me just needs infinity. Relax, take your time. And take your time to trust in me, and you will find infinity. Philosophy. A freak like me just needs infinity. Relax, take your time.
Take your time to trust in me, and you will find infinity.
Other side, he's one of the top juniors in America. Case Matheis is Duke bound.
Really a thrill to watch Case Matheis, number 4. The beauty of him, when I like to see it, when he does it, is he goes, he doesn't beat the first man. He's already got it figured out how to beat the second man before he gets going. Thrill to watch Case Matheis. Should be a great one from him tonight.
Hard to the hole, now back up behind. Matheis looking, dumps it in front. Good defense on the pole that time. Griffin McCarty. Ball's loose in front, and it's an easy one for Case Matheis. An open net, and the Duke Bound Jr. has opened the scoring in the FCAC Finals. Gotta take care of the ball.
Just a simple situation. When he's looking to make the clear, tries to take it back.
can't quite pull it back. They had already pulled the trigger. You see him wanting to pull that one back. And then there's Case Matheis. He doesn't need any help. You don't need to get him going. He's going to do it on his own. An easy one like that can sometimes be a nightmare for your opponent, because once he gets rolling, he'll all be downhill from there.
And now the blue wave in transition. Here comes Bayless Treen. Pass in front. Here's another shot by Case for Cannon-Pounding. Downtown Case Matheis with a little giddy up on that one. And it is 2-0 for the blue wave.
Jim, you see the push up the field here by Darian. Good left-handed shot. Good stop by Winnie. Think he's going to get in the game. And there's that guy again, Jolly on the spot. Case Matheis again, right place, right time. 2-for-2 for number 4.
Case Matheis with 2 goals in a little over 2.5 minutes here in the FCAC. This team starts playing fast and loose. It can be a long night. Here comes Matheis now working. Fires one home. The almighty Case Matheis has 3 goals on 3 shots. He is unstoppable in the first quarter.
Now you want to talk about big guys in big games. Hasn't really dodged yet. That time, outruns the slide, gets going to the right hand. We talked about that speed and that quickness. Tough to keep up with. When you end up chasing him, you're not catching him.
Pat McCabe, I know you love the quick release. That was lightning.
I love the quick release when he's on my side.
Case Matheis, here's a pass opportunity now. Fire on the run and a goal. Here's Darian now in motion, making the extra pass. Look at this. Virtuoso textbook offense by Darian. And Matheis has got his 4th of the game. You can't do it any better than Darian right now.
Jim, I don't care who you're here rooting for. If you're a lacrosse fan, this is what you come to see. Bang, bang, bang. Ends up with number 4. Puts another one in. 7-0 Darian. 10:09 remaining in the second.
43rd of the season for Case Matheis. Here's a pass up front. Only 5 teams have won this championship. Now Case Matheis, look out here. Matheis picks up a ground ball, quickly looking to find somebody. Matheis now firing and scores. He's putting on a show in the FCAC championship. Case Matheis, the drive for 5 is complete. He's got 5 in the first half.
Jimmy talked about his 9 in the state championship. What you see it tonight is inside, outside, the dodging game, the garbage game. This time from deep, 15 yards overhand right. Very strong, gets those hands free. He's tough to stop.
Off the double, it's a goal! Case Matheis to Richard Gregory, and Gregory finishes it off. But it's the footwork of Case Matheis. He gets the defense moving, drops it off to Gregory, and Gregory comes in on the short side.
You know, he talked to you about it, Jim, in your little piece at halftime. This is what he likes to do. He likes to distribute, get his teammates involved.
There's Matheis now. Goes down, draws a penalty. Delayed penalty coming up against Ridgefield. Case, he doesn't care. Doing it all his own, hand on a swivel. Passes across, big shot here, sails over the bar from Bobby Weaver. Oh, Case Matheis, forever the distributor. And you can see the work that Case Matheis put in the off season with the Connecticut Chargers and the camps and the agility training. He trained for speed and quickness. He dedicated the entire off season to this lacrosse season, his junior year. He has got it all. Darian, you get the feeling with 3 minutes left, is 1 goal away from putting it away, up by 3. Matheis, no goals in the second half, 5 in the first. Here he comes, though. You can see the perennial quarterback looking to get somebody involved. Draws the defense right in the middle. This one just goes wide from Preston. Ah, Case Matheis, he puts his teammates in good positions. Well, Case Matheis has gone on record saying there was only 1 thing missing in my career for the Blue Wave of Darien. It was an FCAC championship. Well, Case, The hole has been filled. The void is no more. The Blue Wave of Darien and Case Matheis are FCAC champions. They win it 10-7.
They got going real early. It started with Case Matheis, so let's talk to him right now. Send it down to Steve.
Looking at you.
Yeah, I'm here with the tournament MVP right here, Case Matheis, with just reason, especially in the finals. 5 goals, 3 assists. Case, first of all, how does that feel, tournament MVP?
This is amazing. It's not just about that. It's the fact that we just won the FCAC championship. So we're really happy back in Darien, and we wanted this really badly.
Things got a little tenuous there in the fourth quarter. How'd you guys maintain your composure and not allow that run to spiral out of control?
In the third quarter, we let them back in. I was forcing some passes. We were making some careless mistakes because we thought the game was in our hands. So fourth quarter, we kind of settled down, brought down our excitement levels, and we played well.
Case, 5 goals, 3 assists, I mentioned it. You seem to have a knack in these big games. Last year, state finals, you scored 9 goals. What is it about these big games that makes you play even better than normal?
I love to think of myself as a big game player, and I just love to step it up in these type of games.
All right, Case, one last thing here. This is, you guys have experienced so much at Darien. You're a junior. One thing you never experienced was the FCAC championship.
Yeah,
how does that feel?
This is surreal right now. I love it.
All right, Case, congratulations. Go celebrate.
Thank you.
Jimmy?
Case Matheis, what a victory for him. What a victory for the Blue Wave of Darien.
He's one of the most dangerous guys I've seen at the high school level in a long time.
Well, no one plays with a bigger X on his back than Case Matheis from Darien. Every single scouting report, it's all about stopping number 4 in blue. And teams haven't been successful. He's dominated on the big stage. Last year as a sophomore, 9 goals in the state title game. This year, that trend continued. No one really was able to stop him. Bobby Duvniak played him well from Manhasset. But matchup-wise, no one had the answer for Case Matheis from Darien. Mike, I'm with one of the top players in the nation in Case Matheis in his backyard in Darien. Case, when you think about your stardom or your path to stardom, you have a mother who's from Denver, a father who's from St. Louis. How'd you get the lax bug?
Yeah, growing up, I didn't really know much about the sport. Both my parents didn't know anything about the sport. But in first grade, I joined this program called Blue Wave Buddies, which was brand new at that year. And I started out with the sport. I was kind of iffy with it to begin with. It wasn't really much interest to me. Then. In fifth grade, Dom Finn, a Syracuse legend, was my coach, and he just got me sparked and interested in history from then on.
So as a varsity standout, what's it like to be a star in a hotbed in Darien?
Oh, it's really cool. I know a lot of the younger kids look up to me. I give private lessons sometimes to string their sticks, and it's a really cool community to be a part of. Lacrosse definitely huge here.
You know, your progress has been well documented. When you think about that moment when you knew you arrived and you knew you could take your game to another level, what was it?
I'd say the biggest moment, arrive moment for me was second game of my freshman year against Manhasset. I scored we lost the game 14-13, but I scored 5 goals that game, and it was a really cool moment, and I just knew from then on I had something special here.
You know, your impact on this team is really so valuable, and watching that Wilton game towards the state semifinals, what was it like for you as an injured player?
That Wilton game, just be on the sideline and watching that, not being able to do a single thing, that's one of the hardest things I've ever had to do in my entire life. Just those seniors, those guys like brothers to me during that season, and just I wasn't able to do a thing, and just watching it was really tough.
So what about the summer plans with rehab with the injured MCL?
I actually tore my meniscus, and I'm going to get surgery tomorrow, I think. And I'm thinking about this long term right now. I'm not trying to rush back into anything, and just want to be 100% for next season.
You know, one of the nation's top recruits a year ago that summer you had, I think at the Jake Reed camp and the Maverick Showtime, you were certainly a player on everyone's list. Why Duke?
I say this every time someone asks, just on my visits, just the atmosphere that Coach Nowski, Coach Caputo, and Coach Gabriel create there, it's unmatched in D1 in my opinion. Everything about the school is just top notch, and couldn't ask for anything more.
And when you think about everything that you've done as a player and so much success early on, what drives you in terms of not being complacent?
I just want to be the best out there, and I always set that next goal to have. For a while in youth lacrosse, I wanted to be the first freshman to ever start a Darien, and that goal happened. Now it's we have to finish out our senior years. We didn't win the state championship this year, so it's kind of that's the biggest thing. We have to bring that back to Darien, and then after that, just being the best I can at Duke, and so on and so forth.
In 2009, the Tri-State MVP was Matt White. We know what he did for the University of Virginia, capturing a national title and being all-tournament member. In 2011, Nicky Galasso, last year's recipient of the award, was the Rookie of the Year in the ACC. And this year, it's Case Matheis. And you can't think of a better player and a better kid to get this award, so congratulations.
Thank you very much, Clark. I appreciate it.
And one other thing I'm going to do is we're so used to here at Quick 60 throwing it back to Mike Quick. It's your opportunity now to get it back to the show.
Well, I just want to thank you, Mike, and everyone at MSU Varsity for allowing me to get this award. And I really appreciate all of it. And we want to send it back to you guys at Quick 60.
That was terrific. I mean, great lacrosse player, great kid, and a great TV host. Very good, Case Matheis.
Well, you know, when you talk potential over in Connecticut, everyone is thinking about the potential that is always Case Matheis, and everyone is wondering, can Darien get back on top in 2012 to take back the Class M title, and can they do it with Case Matheis back and healthy?
And saying look out for Darien is sort of like saying look out for the Yankees this year. I mean, you know Darien is going to be there, but Case did have surgery on this meniscus 6 days ago. He came through it beautifully. Now he's entering his senior year. Listen, he's had a lot of guys move on, but Case Matheis, the perennial leader, got that head on a swivel. You expect him in his senior season to try to get back Darien to that promised land. Darien had won 6 straight state titles. Didn't win it this year. Wilt will be back next year. Gives the Blue Wave a little bit of an agenda for Case's senior year.